Assam class 7, today our lecture is number 14, chapter 9. So today we are going to discuss about the topic, first of all, the activity 8.5, in which we have learned that white light is a combination of 7 colors. So you remember that we have studied previous topic, in our previous topic, that whenever we pass the light, white light, through a prism, then we see that there are band of 7 colors. So for this, we are going to doing a activity in which we have a cardboard, a string, and a glazed paper of different colors. Now the procedure is, take a round cardboard, paste equal size piece of glazed paper of 7 colors of light. Then make 2 holes near the center of the cardboard. Make a loop of a string through these holes. Hold the 2 ends of the loop into your hands and also twist the string strongly. Then let loose the string and stretch your hand in and out alternatively. Repeat this again and again. The cardboard will start evolving as shown in figure. Watch carefully the revolving cardboard. Now, first of all, you have a cardboard, a string, and a glazed paper of different colors. Then you have to make equal sizes of pieces of glazed paper and paste it on the round cardboard. Then make 2 holes in the middle of in the center of the cardboard and make a loop of hands string through these holes and hold 2 ends of the loop into your hands and also twist the string strongly. Then loose and stretch the string. You will see that the cardboard revolve, moving. Now you have to watch carefully the revolving cardboard. Then can you still see the different colors on the cardboard? Which color can you see in the revolving cardboard? So that is the experiment in which you see that when continuously you revolving the cardboard, then there is white color only which we have seen. So that is the activity of white light is a combination of 7 colors. Now the next one is rainbow formation. Most of the students have seen that whenever there is a rain and in the presence of sunlight, then some students have seen that there are band 7 colors on the sky. This band of 7 colors is known as basically rainbow. Now, how the rainbow is formed? A rainbow is a natural demonstration of reflection, dispersion, and total reflection of light. So, what is rainbow? A rainbow is a natural demonstration of reflection, dispersion, and total internal reflection of light. When white light of the sun passes through tiny rain drops suspended after rainfall, a rainbow may appear. Okay, how the rainbows appear? Whenever the white light of sun passes through the tiny drops which are suspended in the air, a rainbow may appear. Raindrops in the air act like tiny prisms. Okay, so raindrop in the air act like tiny prisms. They reflect and reflect the sunlight and then separate it into different colors. The color scheme of rainbow is the same as in the spectrum made by the prism, since red color bends the least and violet color bends the most from its original path. So in the rainbow, the red colors appear at the top, whereas the violet colors appear at the bottom. Okay. So the other colors appear in between these two colors. In the diagram, you can see that light from the sun, when it passes through a tiny range, there the both phenomena refraction and reflection take place. First of all, when light enters into the raindrop, you can see there is a refraction because the rays were passing from rare medium to denser medium. And you know that in the laws of reflection, that the rays must be hitting from rare to denser medium. Then for then again, when rays coming out from the raindrop, then the rays were basically passing from denser medium to rare medium. So here the reflection, inside the raindrop, there is a phenomena take place which is known as total internal reflection, because rays are passes through with an angle greater than their critical angle. So that's why there's a total internal reflection phenomena take place. So again, what is a rainbow? Rainbow and how it can be performed? How it can be formed? So a rainbow is a natural demonstration of reflection, dispersion, and total internal reflection of light. So which things are need to make a rainbow? When light of sunlight passing through tiny raindrop suspended after rainfall, a rainbow may appear. So rain drop in the air act like tiny prism. And we have already studied that in our previous lecture, that when our white light transfers from prism, then it have been dispersed in some colors. So same way, a phenomena take place here. When the white light passes through the rain drop, which is act like a prism, so here the total internal reflection and refraction phenomena appear, due to which the white light have been dispersed into seven colors, band of seven color spectrum known as which is known as rainbow. Now the red color bends the least and the violet color bends the most. Therefore, in the rainbow, we see the red color appears at the top and violet colors appear at the bottom, and the other colors lie in between these two colors. So that is the phenomena of rainbow formation. Again, activity, seeing a rainbow. For this, we have a sunny day and also running hose pipe. Procedure: stand with your back to the sun. Okay, so you must have to stand that your sun is in your back, not in front of you. So, and spray water from the hose pipe. Place your thumb over the hole at the end of the hose to get a spraying effect. Then wash the spray against a dark background, glass or wall. Can you see a rainbow in the water droplets of the sprinkling water? Yes. And then what is the color order of these colors from the bottom to top? The order is that first of all red, then yellow, then the other colors at the end. These are violet colors. Now the colors of light, and in understanding of colors is very useful in photography and theater lighting. people who work with lights of different colors must know how to produce light of various colors from a few basic colors. The colors that can be used to make any other light are called primary colors. Okay, the colors that can be used to make any other color are called primary colors. These are red, blue, and green. Now we can mix the light of three primary colors to produce white light, like red, blue, and green. If you mix all three of them, then the white light is appeared. When two primary colors mix, they produce a secondary color like cyan, yellow, magenta, and secondary color. A color television uses different combination of colors. Like if you ever mix the red and green, then the yellow colors appear. If you mix the red plus blue, then the cyan colors appear. And whenever a blue and green color mix, then the magenta color will appear. So basically, in this lecture we have learned that the color that can be used to make any light of the color that can be used to make any other colors are called primary colors. Whereas whenever two or more colors are mixed, then they produce a new color known as secondary color. The primary colors are red, blue, and green, and all others like cyan, yellow, and magenta are secondary colors. Now, there are three types of colors like yellow, cyan, and magenta. Now, from here you can make all of them by mixing. Are they red or green, red or blue, or a blue or green color to make these colors? And also the red and whenever you add the red and green color, then we can obtain other colors of light by mixing light of primary and secondary colors. Here you can see in the diagram, blue, red, and green. Whenever you mix the blue and green color, then magenta color form. Whereas when you mix the red and blue, then the cyan color is formed. Whereas when you mix the red and green, then yellow color is formed. Whenever in the center you have seen that this white color, this is because both three, red, green, and blue color are mixed together, which form the white color. For the activity in which you have learned that mixing the color of light. Here you will need three torches, red, blue, and green cellophane papers. Procedure: take three torches, paste a green cellophane paper on the glass of one of the torch, red cellophane filter on the second, and the blue cellophane paper on the third torch. Throw lights of each color on a white screen in such a way that light of one color falls on the light of the other color. Now mix it of colors and fill the table. That is the experiment that whenever you mix the red and blue color, then the yellow color is formed. When you mix the blue and green, then the magenta color is light blue color is formed, and so on. Now the last topic of today's lecture is colors of objects. When white light shines on non-luminous object, they reflect some colors and absorb all the others. Okay, whenever white light shines on non-luminous object, they reflect some colors and absorb all the others. The color of object is the color of light it reflects. Okay, whenever you fall a light on any medium, and the color which you have seen is basically the color which the body has reflected. Now a red object appears red because it reflects the red color of light and absorbs all the other colors. Whereas the grass of our lawn appears green as it reflects green light into our eyes. Why does a blue car appear blue? Because the blue car accepts all the colors and absorbs all the colors, whereas it reflects the blue color. And when all the colors of light are reflected into our eyes, the object appears white. Okay? Whenever all the colors are reflected, then we see that the color is white. Whereas when all the colors of light are absorbed by the object, it appears black. So black object do not reflect any light. Object of colors other than primary colors reflect mixture of colors. That's why you have seen that in summers, the black body or any body which has black color are always hot because it absorbs all the heat and light from the sun. Whereas the white body do not become so hard because it reflects the most of the light. So that's why white body is not hot as black body. Here you can see that ours, the petals of this rose appears red because they reflect red light, and the leaves appear green because they reflect green light. So class, or today's lecture. Now we have to mark some question that we have learned with. Come to the page number 104 of your book. Here the part number 4 of question number 3 is, what happens when the primary colors of light are mixed in equal proportion? So the answer of this is on page number 101. On topic 9.9, here the last line of this first paragraph is, we can mix the light. So here write when we, now cancel the can, the word can, and again, when we mix the light of three primary colors, it produces white light. The red plus blue plus green is equal to white. So that is answer of question number 3, part number 4. Now the question number 6, what is dispersion of light? Why does white light get dispersed? The answer of this question is on page number 99. Dispersion of light, if you can see the third last line of dispersion of light, the spreading white light into its component colors is called dispersion of light. Now in the next topic, when a beam of light enters a prism from here till the end of the page, white light is obtained. This is the answer of your question number 6. Now the question number 7 is, explain the phenomena in the following diagram. Now the answer of this question is on again on page number 99. Why does white light get dispersed? In this topic, when a beam of light enters a prism, from here to till the end of a beam of white light is obtained. Clear is the answer of your question number 9. So class, now these are the questions that are including in your today's lecture. Now we have completed the chapter number 9 along with its exercise. If you have any kind of question, you can ask. Hurry up.